on track for a positive open after the big two-day sell-off, which did wipe out $1.7 trillion in market value. Will stocks be able to maintain their gains? So far this week, all three indices down more than 6%. Jim, 7 on the S&P, which you think might be time to get interested.
I think you got to start buying something. Now, look, I understand there's two shoes to drop. The cluster that they find in America, you know, look, I say it that way because certainly got the green light to say it from the CDC, and then a possibility of an Ebola situation. Remember, if we lost someone in Texas, that was something that was a problem with the public health system. I think something could happen, something like that here. Would that be shocking? We've lost 14,000 people from the regular flu. So let's say you lose it from a new flu, and perhaps because of a respiratory illness, I think it's certainly possible. I think we keep reading. You're going to read every day about somebody new and about some new area. And that's just the nature of the beast, because the thing is obviously so easily caught. Some UK direction yesterday talking about how if it's on metal for X, you've got to be 6 feet away. I mean, it's just easy to catch it. So I do think it's going to be obviously worse than the regular flu. But we've had 50 million people have the regular flu this year, right, in America. So maybe it goes to 100 million for this thing.
Although we've tried to delineate on this show the difference between the public health aspect and the corporate economic activity aspect. Right. And today we hear from Danone, Diageo, right, Weibo, KLM, Toyota.
Right.
So
we
the
don't
list gets long.
Yes, thank you. We don't know. We're not doctors. And I think you always have to start by saying, here's what the CDC says. Well, supply chain bad, economy obviously weak, and then you get into a situation where you have a TJX reporting a great quarter. So do you just disregard that they reported a great quarter? I don't think so. I think that that's a mistake. Can you file it away? Absolutely. But I can look at some of these stocks and say, all right, how many of them reflected? Do any in travel reflect it? No. Because travel's going to have everybody cuts numbers. Some of these other companies, you know, I was talking to Mark Benioff last night about in Salesforce. Stock's down. We can talk about that because yesterday was step down Tuesday. I don't know if you knew that, Dave.
Step down Tuesday. Is that what it was?
Yeah, it was step down Tuesday.
Yeah.
But, you know, look, let's just say, do you really just want to hate the market as much as you did, minus 7% and haven't bought anything? I can't. My travel trust with 21% cash. Not that I'm a genius, but I just didn't like the. Yeah, I know it's the highest.
That's like Buffett level
Buffett
cash.
That's the only time I've ever been. No, actually, Fortune compared me to Buffett, me and Karen Cramer, in 1989 to the new Buffetts.
Yeah. Did they really?
Yeah,
we don't. Was I'm not sure that was not a specious comparison.
What, because Karen and I broke up? What?
Yeah, that's why.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, that's why.
Hi, Karen. I know she watches
the
show.
Yeah, she watches.
What?
7% not enough, you think, to discount, at least at this point, for the fact that it is coming to this country, that it will conceivably cause disruption, as the CDC seems to be indicating, and that we're going to continue to see corporations curb travel, for example.
Well, yeah, I mean, school's going to be out, the economy's going to slow. I think some companies are beginning to reflect that. I do. I think that the stay is negative, down 7%. It's a little is irresponsible as staying is positive, up 7%.
But why, I guess what David is asking is, why wouldn't you wait for these warnings to come when we know they're coming?
Well, okay, I absolutely know that you want to wait till the warnings come. But I would take a look at, why not watch MasterCard? I had the transition last night on step down Tuesday. They cut numbers, all right? The stock got hit. Now, watch that stock. If MasterCard continues to go down, even though they've already told you that things are going to go down, then you're going to have to say, you know what, even when they warn and get it over with, things can go lower. But again, I'm just saying, if you have a lot of cash, let's say you had 20% cash, are you going to not put 1% to work? Are you really going to think that nobody has anything going on? There were two federal government things that came from yesterday. There was one from the National Institutes of Health came in with basically a hug your children thing. I did not like that. I thought that showed bad leadership. I don't want to be openly critical, but I have to. And then Dr. Fauci came on. He talked about Moderna. He talked about Gilead. Now, he is not. He was the first guy to say, listen, this thing's coming here. Now, he's the first guy to say, you know what, there may be things that happen that are good. So I'm beginning to believe in the science. I'm beginning to think that that there is some risk that they do something good, and you have bought nothing. So I am, look, the first shoe, we've got real problems. We get the cluster. Okay. The second shoe, we get a death. All right. So
instead
you've got
stockpiling canned goods and water the way a lot of my hedge fund buddies are in their second or third homes, they should just be buying stocks.
No, we did that same thing.
Jim already grows his own food out, so you don't have that.
Look, I grow from seed. I would worried about fungus.
I mean, he can choose from around the world where it is he's going to go.
David,
although you got to get on a plane, which is probably not something you may want to do.
David, it's not about me.
It's not?
It's not about me, particularly after yesterday I announced that I was somewhat crazy. I mentioned an animal that was really part of this, maybe this epidemic.
It's part of the coronavirus.
I just don't. If you haven't put anything to work, I think you're playing with fire. I don't think you. Look, I would obviously say put it all to work if I felt you don't have these other shoes. But I'm beginning to hear a different tone from people like Fauci.